Hello everyone, nice to meet you in the CGC 2025 China. Sorry guys, I didn't make it to the CGC stage. Simply, they didn't have enough time for the CPU completion. And some more, my topic is not so related to the repair. So anyway, I'm going to put the video in the YouTube. Hope you enjoy the video. Today my topic is lag and unlag solder base. What do you know about lag? Most of you already know, lag solder paste, they are harmful to our environment. If you look at the data sheet of 183 Celsius solder paste, they used to be written as SN63/PB37. If you look at our element chart here, PB is stand for lead. So mean this kind of solder paste, it has 37% of lead. So this is why it flows so well when we are reball or install the IC. This is what we normally use, especially in this kind of competition. If you want the 138 Celsius of the solder paste, actually they don't have lead. The composition is SN42/BI58. So this is why it's so fragile. It's not recommended to work on FEC connector. It will break easily. So back to the point, lead is not only harmful to our environment. Actually, it is killing us slowly. Now I'm going to tell you how the lag enter to our body. Let's start from the lowest exposure and to the highest. Okay, the lowest exposure, it would be eating. Let's say somehow you forget to wash your hand before a meal or before you're smoking. The adult will absorb 5 to 15%. But the children, if you have kids around, they will absorb 5 times higher than that. So this is the point you should stop any kids to enter your workshop. Second highest exposure is it can enter through the skin, but only some form of lead can enter through the skin that will absorb it. But our kind of solder paste, they are hardly to get in. It is not our concern. Number one, the most dangerous way to get in, which is inhalation. When we solder, the fume, the smoke, it carries microscopic lead particle and the body absorbs it 100%. So what will happen then? The lead will bind into our red blood cell because our body will mistake it as calcium, zinc. This is why our immune system never gonna fight it, never gonna reject it. In the same time, it will also deposit into our bone. This is why some people, they will have a joint pain. There's a lot of small symptoms such as the headache, blah blah blah. But the most scary one actually is the brain damage. Do you know our brain has a natural barrier? It can stop toxic poison that going into the brain. But just because of the lag, our body thought it is the calcium. And then it can enter to our brain, damage neurons, brain cell. Over time, our brain tissue will be badly damaged. The mild symptoms, it would be we have a poor concentrate. Okay, the mood change easily, headache. In long term, even the intelligence, clear mind thinking, memory, they're all permanently reduced. And the worst part is those lag, it never leave. There's no cure if it has entered to the brain. So your first question, it might be, is it happen to all 183 Celsius of the solder paste? Unfortunately, yes. If you want an easy solder, so far there's no replacement for it. Unless you are willing to use 220 Celsius above, those kind of high temp solder paste, they are considered SAC. They are up to the Apple standard, even those other brand they are using that kind. So your question might be, do we have a replacement of the solder paste 183 Celsius, a better one? No, unfortunately, there's no replacement for it. So what we can do is prevention. We better set up a film extractor and then wear a mask. Ideally, it is P100, but it looks stupid and clumsy, so I don't think you're gonna wear it. But how about N95? I think you're smart enough, you can Google about it or ask the ChatGPT, whatever AI you have. You can check the facts. So now let's talk about fun facts. Do you know our world started to use lighted gasoline, lighted fuel, in 1925. And only by 1960, we were getting a lot of complaints regarding children getting brain damage. And there are many lunatics from those industry refinery workers that have brain damage. And then US began banning in 1973. By 1990s, most of the country had followed, but it is a very slow transition. China only banned them in 1997, and then fully removed them by 2000. So it is not very long ago. So if you are born in this period, you kind of have guessed our intelligence is not that high. Those lag in the air, they will not disappear easily. You need to take in. Only by 2021, a last country that has stopped using the lead fuel is Algeria. So in these 100 years, have you wondered why we don't have any breakthrough in scientists? Why we don't have someone else like Einstein, Tesla, Alan Turing? I know you want to say Elon Musk, Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, but they are considered as business people, not scientists. Don't forget, back then, 100 years ago, there's no internet. That's not easy to have communities. Now, if we look at our population, average of IQ, they are much lower than 100 years ago. So, if your kid is born after 2000, or maybe a few years ago, don't be surprised they are smarter than you, because they have grown up in a lag-free world. Remember this, if you want to protect your children, kids absorb 3 to 5 times higher than adults. If your children want to enter to your workshop or even try to play the soldering, you better stop them. So this is also why Apple, Samsung, those kind of big companies, they are not authorized us to repair motherboard. It is not only we don't have a ESD safety system. It is because of health. We don't have a proper ventilation. The solder quality, SOPs, blah blah blah. If you have all that, then those big corporations can award a lot of lawsuits because it really brings harms to humans. Any small complaint, they will lose a lot of money. So they will not take that kind of risk. But as a smaller company, they often ignore it, especially in China. Because you're not gonna see Western country able to sue China company. They are well protected. So I hope after today's conference, we have raised our awareness about lead soldering. So that's it for the video.